Listen, this is exactly what Paul's doing in our Colossians passage. Paul's pointing to an outward practice called fornication. He works it inward to idolatry, or thinking more highly of oneself than one ought to think. And he points back to the nation Israel. He said, "For which thing's sake the wrath of God cometh on the children of disobedience," and he points back to the nation Israel. He just revealed the idolatrous mindset, and he did so by pointing out the failure of Israel. It's easy to see that idolatrous mindset in the scriptural history of that nation. We can all agree. Quite easy to recognize their failure and the separation from God their idolatry brought them. Paul's just pointed it out. The innermost idolatrous mindset, they were guilty. We can all see it, and we can all agree. Now, having pointed out and having established the fact of Israel's guilt, their idolatrous mindset, their love of self, Paul turns on his heels in a manner of speaking. He points directly at us. And he's going to show us as we work our way through this passage that what Lucifer was guilty of in the garden, that what Adam and Eve were guilty of, what the nations prior to the nation of Israel were guilty of, what the nation Israel was guilty of, what the carnal Corinthians were guilty of, what the members of the body of Christ at Rome were guilty of, with a mirror turned directly toward our faces, your face, my face, Paul's going to prove, thou art the man. Thou art the man. Separation is the result. Separation from God? Could we be separated from God? In what sense could we be separated from God? Separation was the result of all the previous examples I've given you. In what sense could self-glorification separate those who are among us right here from God? For the answer, watch the screen next week. We'll bring it to you then. Interesting things. But remember, Paul's taking us to the ultimate level of spiritual maturity here in this passage in Colossians. As Paul called it, the measure of the stature of the fullness of Christ. Stay with us. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you so much once again for your word. We thank you that you've told us how to study it, that we might make sense of it, that it might open up to us and we might understand what you've accomplished for us at Calvary. What a wonderful God you are to accomplish a salvation which our fingerprints will never be found on. We must simply rely upon the fact that Christ took our sin, every bit of it, past, present, future, died for that sin, was buried, putting that sin out of your sight forever, rose again, having established our justified standing before you. We thank you so much that he did it all. He did all the giving. He did all the doing. We do only all the receiving. We thank you. Help us to, in the days ahead, to take these things in, to put them where they belong in our minds, to sort them out, to apply them where they need applying. We just thank you for your word, for all it accomplishes in us as we take it in faithfully, study it, rightly divided, and apply it to our lives. For it's in Christ's name we pray. Amen.